Hey everyone, it's Lisa back today creating a tutorial for you. This one's going to cover half double crochet stitch when you're creating a grafkin. So the first thing that we're going to do is go ahead and start out with a chain of 20. So remember, we're using the half double crochet stitch. So it calls for a chain of 20, but you're going to add two extra chains. And this is going to be for your turning row, okay? So we'll go ahead and chain 22. Okay, so once you have your 22 chains, remember, it's half double crochet. So we're going to start in 1, 2, the third loop from the hook. That is going to be 20. Okay, so that should give you 20 half double crochets when you're working back across. So first, second, third. So we're going to go ahead and create our first half double crochet and continue to half double crochet all the way across to the end. When you get to the end of your half double crochet row, you're going to chain two, turn, and then we're going to go in 1, 2, 3, 4, the next four stitches with half double crochet, and then we're going to do a color change. So 1, 2, 3, 4. On your fourth one, remember you don't complete your stitch. You go ahead and drop your yarn, pick up your next color, and on this one we're going to be dropping to the front, so we can see the difference between dropping to the front and dropping to the back of your work. And you can judge to see which looks better, if it's any difference that you see, and what you prefer. So we're going to go ahead, dropping our gold to the front, brown, whichever color you prefer to be, picking up the turquoise, pulling through, and we're going to carry the brown and the turquoise tail with us, okay? So go ahead and three turquoise, and then three half double crochet in the next three stitches. Okay, I'm going to drop the turquoise to the front, drop the tail, pick up our other color. And continue working across. Okay, let's go ahead and do another color change here. Dropping to the front. We're going to pick up white. Add the white in. Dropping the tail to the front. Pulling through. This time we're going to leave our color, okay? And continue to work the white across and taking the tail with us. And as you can see, I'm just holding on to the tail as I go through and just hiding it in my work. So, and you don't have to carry the tail. If your preference is to weave it in, you can always leave your tail and then weave it in later. This just for me is easier so that I don't have to weave later on. So I'd rather just carry. So, and then we're gonna go ahead and work the white all the way across, chain two, turn, working the white back across, When we get to this point, we're going to drop the white, pick up our brown that we were working with, now as you notice, if I just pick up the brown in the back and don't pull it back over, it's going to kind of bleed over into that white. So what I do is when I pick up the brown, I want to leave it over far enough so that when I do that first half double crochet, I'm going, just trying to make sure that you see, I'm going through the stitch, the brown is being pulled back over, okay, so that way it's not bleeding into your color. To me, it's important because it just makes for a clean look. So that way, as you can see, when you go back through, let me turn it so you can see. When you're pulling it back over, it's not bleeding into this other color. Vices, let's do it the other way, and let me show you. So if we were just to pull it up and not worry about catching it and go ahead and do our half double crochet, this is what you would see. And again, this can be, let me pull it down some so you can see it. This could be preference. For me, I just like for the next color that I'm working on not to show through. You can work it either way, see which one you prefer, and then go from there. But like I said, I prefer to pull it over. If your preference is not to, that's okay too. Just depends on how you want your work to look. Okay, we're gonna drop, pick up our turquoise, give a little tug on that brown. go ahead and work your turquoise through. I kind of held on to it when I pulled it over, so that way to make it easier when I'm pulling the stitch through. Okay, last one. Okay, with the last turquoise, remember we're changing colors. So I'm gonna grab a new piece. I did not carry, the reason I didn't carry the brown under the turquoise is because it's gonna bleed through. So I went ahead and grabbed a new bobbin. Create my color change. Tug on the turquoise, and I'm going to carry the tail for this one across to hide it also. Okay, and at the end of the row. All right. Okay, so at the end of the row, I just want you to take a quick look. So this is done half double crochet. So the spacing is a little bit wider. Depending on, you want to make sure if you are working a pattern in half double crochet that it's been written up that way for you. Because if not, and it's been written up for either single crochet or Tunisian, then it's gonna have a different look to it. And it's gonna be much bigger than what you're expecting the outcome of the pattern to look. So I just want to show you, if you're dropping to the front, this part, which looks very clean, is actually your back. Okay, this would be the back of the work. Turn it. And this would be the front of your work. Okay, so like I said, as far as dropping to the front or the back, I know there's other people who say, hey, drop to the front. I just prefer the look when the yarn is dropped to the back, vices drop to the front. So I'll leave that as your preference. When I do create a piece though, I am gonna always say drop to the back. So this, as you can see, is a piece created in half double crochet. Let me show you the piece that I'm also working on. And this okay, and this piece is worked in single crochet. Okay. Front, the back of the work. So as you can see, let's see, comparing the two pieces. Like I said, the holes on the half double crochet work are a little wider than the single crochet. The stitches are a little tighter. And I think with working in single crochet or half double crochet, it is a preference. I would say maybe work up a, if you're trying to decide if you want to work in single crochet or half double crochet, work up two small swatches and see how they look. You know, which one you prefer, which look you prefer. And then you'll know before you start your graphgan which one that you want your blanket to look like, and then just go from there. I know this was a really quick tutorial. I'm gonna have another one coming out. It's just that I kept promising a half double crochet look, and I just wanted you to see how it looks worked up. I'll have another video coming out soon. Please just bear with me, and thanks again for watching.